Today we go over Star Wars Episode 9, the final film of the Skywalker saga and the sequel trilogy alike. This is Mike Zier here. If you guys are new to the channel, do make sure to subscribe to see future Star Wars content. Now, as you all know, Episode 9 is the final film of this trilogy. It is a big deal because Disney and Lucasfilm, they will be selling this movie off as the end of the end in order to make it into a mega event come December of 2019. Now, I wanted to get on the subject of time travel. Now, this has been a huge subject ever since the release of the Star Wars Rebels Season 4 episode, Worlds Between Worlds, where we see Ezra Bridger essentially changing the entire past, saving Ahsoka Tano from Darth Vader killing her. And we see all of the events unfold and change for, you know, the future itself. Now, looking at Episode 9, since J.J. Abrams has actually messed around with the concept of time travel before in the past, and there was a lot of talk in the past that Dave Filoni was actually talking with Rian Johnson and J.J. behind the scenes here and there. By the way, Dave Filoni, I believe, was also talking with Jon Favreau with his live-action TV series. So everybody's checking in with everybody, trying to align everything up correctly. And a lot of people have been talking about the possibility of time travel in Episode 9 in order to change elements from the past and how that could very well change, you know, certain things in the future, especially after the events of Episode 9 even. Now, to me, I think it would be a good thing only to change certain events that happened in The Last Jedi. It would be a great way for Disney and Lucasfilm to essentially correct some of the problems, such as saving Luke Skywalker from sudden death from using the force projection technique. A lot of people would throw jokes around like, you know, Luke essentially overdosed on the force or something around those lines. But nonetheless, I thought that the visuals for Luke's death were just beautiful, with the sunset, him on the cliff. I mean, that was honestly breathtaking. But it was way too soon for him to die in the sequel trilogy. So that is one thing that I would love to see actually be changed in the sequel trilogy by use of time travel. Otherwise, though, it could really get a little outlandish with the use of time travel in Star Wars, especially within Episode 9, because then it's kind of like you can just change anything at that point in time. Now, sure, in the Worlds Between Worlds episode, you kind of see how limited it really is. So we'll have to wait and see if J.J. Abrams touches on this element in Star Wars, whether or not it has to do with changing moments from the past within The Last Jedi, or maybe even well before the events of the original trilogy that could very well change parts in Episode 9. I mean, who knows what J.J. is going to do in this film, right? My point here is, do you guys think it's a good or a bad idea in order to insert the element of time travel in a Star Wars movie such as Episode 9 in order to change the past? Now, to me, I feel like it works in a TV show, specifically an animated TV show, like, you know, Star Wars Rebels, or if they decide to do this in a future show, so be it. But I'm not quite sure if it would really work in a live-action film for Star Wars as a whole. I just feel like that it sounds good on paper, but it's not, you know, great to be seen on screen. I don't know how that would really be done. But looking at the concept and all, I think it would be great to correct some of the issues within The Last Jedi and kind of just give us a different timeline in Episode 9. Little moments, like little things here and there. Maybe they could save Luke. Maybe they could do this or that, you know? Change little elements here and there. If they don't want to do that, they could always insert the idea of flow walking. Now, flow walking is a thing for Force users. I don't know if you guys knew this, but Darth Cadus actually was able to pull this move off in the EU / Legends material. I think it was you could essentially only see the past, but not change the past. So you couldn't change any moments in time, but you could see everything. You could actually interact with time, but you couldn't change it. So I would like to see something like that be applied in, you know, Star Wars Episode 9 with both Kylo and Rey. Perhaps maybe they gain the ability to flow walk. If Kylo Ren is a flow walker, or if Rey is a flow walker, I like that name, by the way. I think personally it would be great to see the truth of the Jedi and or Sith and get a bigger idea of what went on in the past and a better idea of what you could actually do at this point in time in order to rebuild the Jedi Order or whatever Kylo Ren wants to do. But let me know what you guys have to say about all of this in the comments, and if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.